everyone. Welcome to the vlog. We're going to Dubai.
I am so excited. I can't believe I look like that.
I can't believe I look like that.
We've just eaten, so we're just waiting to find out what gate we're flying from, where we're going. But I don't think that comes out until 7:55.
I just need to get some snacks for the plane.
Yeah, Georgia's scared she's not going to like the aeroplane food, so.
I never like the aeroplane food.
But Emirates aeroplane food is nice.
Well, we'll see. But just a snack in case. Just some crisps, you know?
Just a crisp?
Just a crisp, that'll do me. But anyone, anyone worried about going on? No, who's worried? But the airport's so easy.
Yeah, it's not stressful.
And no one's wearing a mask. Well, we're not really.
Well, we just...
Oh, I have that on the wrong way.
I thought yours looked less pink than mine.
What's that?
Yeah, like, we were wearing masks, obviously, but we were eating, so we took it off. But no one is wearing a mask.
So, I mean, it says, like, to be fair, but only seen one sign saying you have to... Oh, there's one there. Saying you have to wear a face covering.
But, I mean, it keeps, like, flashing up on the screen.
Yeah, but, like, no one's...
Like, this many people can't be exempt.
Absolutely not. But no, I don't think anyone cares.
No, no one said anything.
I mean,
anyone.
We don't care. We would rather not.
Yeah.
But
got to wear it for 7 hours on the plane, so... Rather not wear it in here.
Mm.
Oh, I've got a spot.
We will look better than this for the rest of...
The remainder of the trip.
Because this is quite embarrassing, actually.
Barely a vlogger. I forget to do it all the time. I was getting my nails done yesterday. Julia kept going to me, the vlog. I was like, oh, sorry.
But it's my birthday trip.
It's George's birthday on Friday.
Guess how old I'm going to be? 24. I'll save you the guess.
I'm going to be 24.
I really do have a fear of aging, so I am freaking out a little bit on the inside. But I think the fact I'm not going to be in the country is 100% going to make me feel
good. Oh, well. Yeah, definitely.
Definitely.
I think it's just easier not planning anything for your birthday.
Yeah.
No pressure.
Literally. And like no pressure to have a good time, because at the end of the day on a holiday I'm already going to have a good time.
Yeah.
So it's not like I have to like make sure I'm going to be by the pool, I'm going to have a good time.
True.
And we're going for a great, I booked some great restaurants.
Every day when I was at work she was messaging me, I just booked this restaurant for... Thursday, just booked this restaurant for Saturday.
Literally. And it was a struggle, I'm not gonna lie. Like,
yeah.
Some of them were very difficult. I've just realised
what
I didn't bring that card that I confirmed the booking with for.
Surely it's not gonna matter.
No, I don't think it will. I don't think it will. They just needed the card details to confirm the booking. If we pay with a card. Like our normal cards, like, I mean,
there's nothing we can do now.
It's above me now. There's
nothing we can do.
It's literally game over. I'm at Heathrow Airport. What
do
you want me to do?
And Dad can't come back. But yeah, I'll do another update later when we're on the plane, perhaps. Maybe just when we get there.
Room tour.
But yeah, see you in a bit.
Get away from the books. We're not reading.
Oh, is my mask right now?
Yeah.
Am I thinking?
What?
Jumbo bag
of minions. Oh my god, what a dream. Oh no, there's just 10 bags in there. Oh.
Guys, we're on a double-decker plane. Never been on one of these before. I'm excited.
I'm excited.
Mum said send QR codes.
I'm sorry, what?
For the returns.
Oh, for my
face looks so tanned.
I thought she meant send QR codes, like, as in, like, for our flight. I was like, what are you talking about?
Are you going to track it?
Are you on Skyscanner?
Also, look at these chairs. They're, like, laying. Like, laying.
Really enjoying it.
So much fun.
Sunbed.
Lounging. But yeah, got about 40 minutes till our flight.
having a great time. I just can't believe we're on a double-decker plane. I'm so excited about that. However, I don't know if it's going to actually affect us, because I think that just the upstairs is for first class.
Yeah. We ain't going double nowhere, mate. We're the poor person in the poor section.
We ain't going upstairs.
Honestly, and as well, basically, when you check in, there's like two sides, and it's like business class. Oh my god, I look tan.
Yeah, literally, I don't know what's going on.
Business class and first class go like that way, and economy that way. And literally, we were like, to the left. Oh my god, this is the funniest. It's not gonna. The water just rolled away. Shauna's fucking putting it there. Anyway, this isn't gonna sound funny, but it was funny. Basically,
this husband and wife checked in, but they checked in separately.
I don't understand. Because we went to the desk together.
Yeah, you are allowed to go to. So he was on this side and she was on this side, and he walked over. She was already checking in.
Yeah.
He walked over
with his little roll along case.
And she ran up to him.
She was like, "He's got my bag."
Literally, like, in such a fluster. And we were laughing because we were like, that's literally our mum.
But also, I don't think normal people would find that funny, but I could cry. It was so funny.
We were literally in the queue, cracking up. Everyone's probably looking at us thinking, what the fuck?
And the thing is as well, we like to drag a joke on, so we'll probably do that all week.
Probably laugh about it for the rest of the week.
Oh god.
Yeah, but yeah, really enjoying these chairs. Really excited about the double decker plane.
I'm excited. Basically, I already looked at what films are on there, because I'm like that, and some great films, can't wait to watch.
But yeah, oh, someone's scary just commented on my Instagram picture. Anyway, see you in Dubai.
Morning everyone, sorry about the state of the room. I didn't vlog when we got here yesterday because we were so tired. So we literally came in, like checked in and everything, sorted everything out, and just got food and went to sleep because it was too much. But it's about 10 in the morning. Oh, you can see my back. There's mirrors everywhere in this room. Yeah, it's about 10 o'clock. We're about to go down for breakfast. My necklace is all twisted. I just got ready, so I'll show you guys my bikini choice for the day. So just a black with my beach trousers, and I've got my belly chain on, but you can't see that with my trousers on. So yeah, probably gonna have to put a top on to go downstairs for breakfast, but this is the fit. So this is our view from our room. So the pool is there, and then this is just other people's apartments, and then the main road. So we're on the Palm, one of the Palm Islands. I don't know which one, please don't ask me. Yeah, cute, right? I'm excited. Excited for day one. Just wanna lay in the sun, really. That's what I'm excited about. Oh, can't get back in. Ooh. So yeah, we're gonna go down for breakfast. I'll show you guys breakfast. Just finished breakfast. Basically just had fruit and waffles. That was it. Georgia's super sweet.
That's basically exactly what she had.
But I got this fruit, and I don't know what it is. It was okay, but it tastes a bit like banana, which is confusing to me because it's obviously not
a
banana.
Did it not have a sign? I saw it, but I thought it was melon.
I think it might be papaya. I'm not sure.
Shauna got in trouble.
Yeah, I got in trouble. So I showed you guys my outfit with the beach trousers. I'm not allowed to wear them because they're see-through, which is fine, but Like, I understand. However, if someone had have told me beforehand, or if there was a sign outlining what can be worn and what cannot, then I wouldn't have worn them in the first place. My hair is a mess, sorry. I'm gonna put the scarf back on my head so that it doesn't burn. But I had to take it off, I had to put the mask on, and it was a whole thing, and it was just too stressful for me. So yeah, George is just gonna finish up her fruit if she stopped dropping it all over herself.
It's the pineapple, it's hard to buy. And I don't want to shove the whole chunk in my mouth.
So yeah, that's that really. Show you guys the pool when we eventually get there. And there's a lazy river, which is fun.
I'm so buzzing about that.
Same, I love a lazy river.
We love the lazy river.
My favourite thing ever.
Oh.
But yeah, so.
Hello. Just having a chill. My hair is completely fucked. Went in the lazy river, then went in the pool. And this is what I'm left with. It is so hot. So hot. Like, I've been in and out of the sun, but like, I can't stay there for too long. Literally dying. And I had to take the scarf off my head because I was trying to protect my head from getting burned. However, it was making me sweat, so it just was not a good idea.
I'm dark. Look at this.
I'm like a mime.
Yeah, literally. We are currently out for dinner. I forgot to even like show you my outfit. I'm the worst at this. I'm so bad. But yeah, I'll show you my outfit afterwards. Obviously, I can't right now because it's literally darkness. But yeah, we're out for dinner at...
Eula?
Eula.
I don't know if it's Eula or Eula, but it's U-L-A. That is the spelling.
I'm going to say Eula.
It means sea
jewel.
It came out so fast.
Oh my god, so fast. Came out at the same time as our drinks. So we literally, it was drink gear offs. I was like, God, what's going on? But yeah, food was 10 out of 10. This is our view.
Beautiful. Stunning. I didn't realise my flash was on. That's embarrassing. There's George and Marcantonio. And wow, that autofocus on the iPhone. I
think it was a G7X, right? But yeah, just currently enjoying my cocktail.
I didn't think that I was going to get served because I'm not even 21. But they didn't ask, so...
To be honest, though, like, you look older than me and I'm about to...
That's not talking about it.
Talk about my age. But you look older than me, so I don't think they would ever...
Yeah, so they didn't say anything, so fingers crossed. No one will for the remainder of the trip.
Really? I literally will.
One option. There's no front flash.
Alright.
Okay. It's this or nothing.
Alright.
Georgia just wants to let everyone know...
This is a public service announcement, right? If you are considering ordering a dish that has a truffle in it in a restaurant, number one, don't. Just don't full stop. Number two, if you're going to, check if I'm there. If I'm near, in the vicinity where I'm going to get a whisk, right, I don't want to smell it. Do you know what it smells like? Men's or deodorant? That's a very specific smell, right?
And that is what truffle smells like. To be fair, since you've said it,
yeah. And I can't, you know what it is? It. One of them smells well. Once you've got it in your nose, you cannot get it out of your nose.
Need to smell like, some coffee granules.
Literally, like, it's like at a perfume factory where you're like, I've sniffed something. Like, it makes you feel sick and it's just disgusting. And also, anyone who is on Instagram or whatever saying truffle this, truffle that, they're lying. Like, it's disgusting.
If you say you like it, don't be that guy because no you don't. You don't. You're a liar. What actually is it? It's actually, I can't remember off the top of my head, but I know it's something vile as well because pigs, imagine how dirty pigs are. Pigs, like, root in the ground, like, to dig up truffles. I'm sure that's true. I'm sure that's true. And if I'm wrong, don't correct me.
I'm sure it's true.
And that's disgusting.
It's disgusting.
So basically, the moral of the story, don't order anything that has truffle in it. It's disgusting.
It's not. I always thought it was like mushroom.
I thought that, but I'm sure I googled it and it was something vile as well. And I was like, that makes sense for the fucking smell of it.
Disgusting. I do feel a bit sick now.
Ooh. I'm gonna Google it.
I knew it was true. So yes, it's a type of mushroom or a type of fungi, but pigs, dig it. Dig it. Disgusting.
Steve, we are back.
Hello.
In the bedroom.
Where we belong, in the free rooms.
Look at the makeup around the neck of mine.
Mate, look at the fucking pocket hanging off of mine. I'm not impressed, I have to say. That weren't me.
Well, mine doesn't even have loopholes. Yeah, I just have to hug it around me and then hope for the best. Dinner was...
delicioso. 10 as we 10. Knew it would be. I'm just hoping that I can keep up my track record of good restaurant choices all week because I've booked them all, so it's actually a little pressure on my shoulders.
I mean, you're doing well so far.
I'm doing well so far. One down, tick.
Six, five to go.
Yeah, but was delightful. Oh, how convenient. Also, Shauna conveniently forgot her card for dinner.
I will send you the money. You actually didn't remind me when we got back up here, so...
Oh, how dare I? Do you know what? I will be reminding you tomorrow. Bring your fucking debit card, you absolute cheapskate.
Whatever.
It's my birthday. I'm fucking paying for everything.
I'm going to send it to you. Gonna make me go mental in a minute.
You keep saying that word
again and again and again. Also, happy St. Patrick's Day to everyone who celebrates.
It is St. Patrick's Day now here in Dubai.
If you didn't know, me and Georgia are professional river dancers.
That is the truth. We don't like to brag about it.
Don't brag about it.
Talk about it.
But we are professionally trained in the river dance world.
And if you're lucky,
we'll show you.
We'll give you a little Irish jig tomorrow morning, just for the Paddy's Day vibes. By the way, we are literally half Irish. We're not taking the piss here.
Yeah, no, genuinely. Literally. We cannot Irish dance. We like to think we can.
After a drink, most definitely can. But certainly we're not taking the piss. Our grandparents are literally from Dublin. We are Irish. We
yeah, love we're it. Not lying.
No, we're not shit.
We don't have the we're dress.
Not, no.
Imagine if we had the dresses.
Mate, don't. Mum should... Oh.
Don't worry, it doesn't stop.
Mum should have literally... She said
basically she said that she tried
younger,
to get us to do it.
She was going
to
take us Irish dancing. We said we didn't want to go. Okay, well, I'm four. So you say...
Force me, because that is a talent I would like to now have.
And jig away. That's what she should have said. Because
shake them toes.
Literally, because I'm not being funny. I pull it out like it's my party trick.
Can't fucking do it.
Can't even do it.
We're literally just hopping and...
When I've had a drink, I do like to think I can.
Mate.
But the truth is, I can't.
We're going to show you guys tomorrow.
Yeah.
Our talent.
We'll give you a St. Patrick's Day special.
Anyways, Prob's gonna go bed now, so.
Probably should. Okay, what's the time here?
I don't know.
It's 11 minutes past one here, but the issue is, this is our problem, right? The UK's 4 hours behind, so at home it's only like 10 past nine. And first of all,
she's
fine.
Sorry.
First of all, all our friends are still awake, so we chat.
Yeah,
chat,
like, everyone's you know trying I mean? To talk to
we're
me.
Missing out on life if we go sleep. And also,
sorry.
We need to post our pictures, our Instagram pictures on UK time, right?
Yeah.
So we have to stay awake to post.
It's so, quite the palaver.
Yeah, it's really
but think time for bed now.
Yeah. Got to take our makeup. Well, we're going to be another 20 minutes at least. Got to take our makeup and brush our teeth, so.
Yeah, litro. Prob's going to have a chat. If Georgia doesn't try to kill me in my sleep again tonight. Literally,
do you
right?
think that's the truth?
Literally, yeah, right? I'm laying here like this at sleep last night, right? Georgia comes. I went, oh my fucking God. And then I was like, Jesus Christ, literally scared the life out of me, woke me up, and then she just turned over, went on her phone, completely ignored the fact that she gave me a heart attack.
Well, I'm not being funny, I turned over in my sleep.
Shauna's there, right? I was like, that's her head.
Okay. I was not there.
I was like, can't push you over because you'll probably punch me in the face. So I was like, right, I'll just be on the edge then all night like this.
Oh, you are so dramatic.
I'm not.
If
I'm,
I was I'm like that, honest. If I was like that, I was only like that for max an hour.
You were like that when the alarm went off in the morning.
Yeah, and I'd been awake since 7 because you tried to kill me.
It's not true. I turned over just to, you know, turn over.
Well, after you woke me up.
Like a psychopath. I was having a really good dream and she woke me up and then I couldn't get my dream back.
After you woke me up and tried to kill me, I couldn't get back to sleep for an hour. And the alarm went off at 9:30. So if I fell back asleep at, say, 8 a.m, I was not there the whole night. I was there for an hour and a half. And you owe me that after trying to literally murder me.
Oh my God.
At 7 a.m.
Get a grip, would you?
Literally turned over like a monster in the bed.
Not a monster.
Literally was, I was terrified. Jumped out of my skin. I thought someone had come into the room. So you were going,
oh, fucking drop me out. First of all, if someone had come into the room, I would just turn over and squeal. I would scream at the top of my lungs, intruder!
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 You remember them intruder alarms in school?
Wee!
Yeah, literally. Wee!
And bear in mind, actually, when they went off, I was in maths and we all got locked in the classroom. First of all, the door is glass, so if there was a genuine
and there was a massive glass window,
literally they will fucking get us, let me tell you. I don't think a little lock.
I remember one time it went off when I was in English. My English teacher, right, everyone get under the table. I was like,
for goodness sake.
We're literally all sitting under our desks like,
for God's sake.
And it was just a person, it was a person who was a student at the school who had been excluded.
I'll drop me out. Well, to be fair, the time it went off when I got locked in my math classroom, one of the receptionists had set it off by accident. So
one time I remember it went off, this boy in my class had been sent out, and then the alarm went off, so he was knocking on the door like, can I come back in?
For God's sake. Ridiculous.
So funny. Anyways, bedtime. Hopefully I'll make it out alive.
You won't at this rate.
Night.
Night.
Hello again. Welcome back. It's currently Friday. I didn't vlog at all yesterday. I forgot. I'm really sorry. But today is George's birthday.
Ooh.
24.
Stop.
So yeah, we're just chilling on the beach. We're going to a restaurant called... Sorry, choking. We're going to a restaurant called Opa tonight, so that'll be fun. We can smash the plates.
Can't wait.
I kept my period this morning, so that was really upsetting for me and my spirit. But yeah, just having a chill, having a relax. Show you the beach.
Love the beach.
It's a little bit windy today, which I'm not really mad about because it's making the sun a bit more bearable.
That's what I mean. It's just easier to lay in it when there's a breeze.
Yeah, like, definitely.
And you don't feel like, oh my God, I'm...
Sorry, I'm literally choking.
To death. You just feel like, oh, this is great. Although at breakfast, we were sat in the shade and it was so windy and we sat outside, so we actually cut.
It was actually quite goosebumps, chilly.
So I was like, this could not be it on my birthday, but...
But yeah, just look like a sweaty mess at the moment. I promise I'll look nice later and I'll try and do better with the vlog because I'm literally the worst. Guys, there's these birds on the beach. I'm really scared. Like, literally terrifying me. I don't know where they've gone now. They're literally like black, like big black birds. Like crows, they look like crows. I'm gonna start crying.
They are crows.
Are they?
I think they're crows. I mean, I'm not a bird expert.
They're ginormous, like monster birds.
And I was sitting here literally nearly crying, and Georgia was just taking a selfie. I was like, I'm gonna have a panic attack in a minute.
But the thing is, you're constantly terrified. I can't be on watch 24/7. I'm trying to enjoy my holiday.
Georgia, I will have a heart attack.
Oh, I know, I'm sorry.
Have you just taken that headscarf off again after I've tied it up for you again?
It's slipping off my big fat head. My head's too big. I can't.
We're not going to be mates in a minute.
That bird.
Oh my gosh,
can you see?
Oh,
look at the bird. How scary are them birds?
Actually, stare at me in the My actual panicking, like literally every 5 minutes on this beach I'm going, ooh, and everyone's looking at me like I'm insane. It is so scary. Hate it.
That's what happens outside of the beach versus the pool, but then again they were at the pool, so just less.
Can't get away from birds. What the purpose of birds?
You know there's live birds at the restaurant, they are.
Are you taking the piss?
Yeah, I'm joking.
I was about to say, I'm not coming.
What, dinner for one? On my
birthday? I will not come. Terrifying.
Really? Why did I do that?
I don't know. I feel like that is the kind of sick joke you would play on me.
I wouldn't do that. I'm not that much of a bitch.
Hello, everyone. Back again. Just got ready.
Oh, careful.
I know.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I've got no trousers on.
It's currently 5:30. We don't have dinner booked till 7:30.
No.
But it was a bit windy.
Well, it was a bit cold.
And also I'm burnt and I didn't realise. But like patchy. Like look. It's quite ridiculous. So yeah, we came upstairs and got ready a bit earlier. I still need to do my hair and decide what I'm wearing, because now that I'm burnt, I don't know what to wear, because everything is going to display the redness,
yeah,
which is an issue for me.
But we're both hungry.
Very hungry. Like, my stomach could rumble any second.
Literally,
I'm quite
so starving. Really excited for dinner. But dinner will be good tonight, I think. I'm expecting good things from the food.
You look so funny.
I know. I've got all my hair in, like, pins.
It won't let me zoom.
Good, that's for the best. Yeah, but food will be good, hopefully, because I'm gonna eat so much I don't even care.
Well, you have to get a starter, main and dessert in this restaurant.
Yeah, bit rude actually.
Bit like, sumptuous.
How dare you demand me? The thing is, the starter and the main thing I get, but some people don't like dessert. Like some people don't like dessert. Like dad
for example, does not eat dessert.
Would never have dessert ever. He's just got to order it for the sake of it. Bit rude. I don't even know.
To
what
be
the
fair
are.
Though, well they've got. I don't want to say it wrong.
Baklava.
Yeah, and I want to try that.
It is meant to be delicious.
I've never had it before in my life, so I don't know whether to risk it and get it. Or...
Well, I mean, you've got to pay for it anyway, so just try it, and then if you don't like it, don't like it.
True. And I burnt my hand, which
Did
is
you?
Ugly.
Shauna, what happened today?
I don't know, because me and you were laying in the sun for the same amount of time. We wore the same amount of sun cream.
We reapplied sun cream the same amount of times.
Like,
and I haven't even got a hint of a colour, let alone burn.
Yeah, I don't get it. Like, I really don't know what happened. I'm a bit annoyed, to be fair. So yeah, gonna finish getting ready. I'll actually show you guys this restaurant because I've been pretty shit and I haven't.
This restaurant's fun.
Yeah.
Like the thing is, the other restaurants have been lovely.
But so dark.
But very, like the vibe is obviously music and darkness.
Yeah.
But that's not what it's like.
But like I can't vlog in there because it's like awkward. I'll have my flash on. Everyone will be like, what is this bitch doing? So yeah, this restaurant is not that like that. So I will be vlogging. I will show you the restaurant, the vibes, the food, and yeah.
So I'm ready now. I'll show you my outfit. I had to kind of cover myself up because of the burn, so but you can still kind of see it. I'm just gonna hope and pray that the shirt covers it up enough. Georgia's
in a gorgeous blue dress, but she's taken out her hair at the moment, so she doesn't look like a 40s housewife. But yeah, so the whole outfit is from Pretty Little Thing. I'm wearing it with this bag, which is George's bag, which is from Pretty Little Thing. Cute, right? And I'm wearing my favourite heels from Ego, the white ones, which I showed you in my previous video. If you watched that, if you didn't watch that, you're a snake. Ooh, birthday girl! Woo! So this is the full outfit. And George is just taking a picture in the mirror. These mirrors are all down this hallway. It's great news. Lighting's actually not bad here. Hesitant to wear this outfit. I didn't think I was gonna wear it. I bought it as like a backup outfit, but I think it's quite cute. If the birthday girl could hurry up. I'm coming, sorry. Some of us are very hungry. Woo, happy birthday.
Thank you.
24. Also, the lifts in this hotel are so dumb. It's like this stupid touchscreen thing to get where you want to go, and it never works properly. It's so irritating. Back in the room, back in the robe. Back where we belong. Sorry about that. We had the best dinner ever. Not to say everyone should come to Dubai, but they should. But if you come, go to Opa. Like, it's actually the best restaurant I've ever been to.
It was fantastic in my life. Restaurant.
In the whole world of places I've been.
Just like, the food was amazing. The service was amazing.
So friendly, so nice.
And then it's like, I can't. Ow!
She just hit her burn. She burned a lot today, guys.
I just burned a lot today, and I just whacked it like a twat. But yeah, just a fantastic all-round experience. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll have seen my stories. Obviously, just inserted videos. Previous.
Yeah, it was just unreal. Like, and I was dying. Like, before we came to Dubai, I follow quite a lot of like influencers and stuff on Instagram, so I'd seen like so many people go to Opa, and I was like, Shauna, this is so like, looks so fun. I was dying to go, and it was the best decision to go there, like on the day of my birthday.
Fantastic experience.
Unreal. Honestly amazing. And the waiter was in love with Shauna. In love. He couldn't get enough. He just was hovering around constantly. I was like thinking, do you want to pull up a chair?
Like, I tried to get in because we ordered like grilled halloumi. I like picked up the fork to put it on my plate, and he like ran over.
Oh, let me serve you. Let me serve you.
I was like, okay, Mark.
Mark with a K.
Kark. We were literally sitting there the entire time just calling him Carcass, and no one had any idea.
Honestly.
Oh my god, also them girls at the beach earlier. Their conversation. So we were sitting behind, so we was on the, there's three rows on the beach. We were in the back row today. These two girls came and laid in front of us. I don't know where they were from. They sounded like they were American.
American or Canadian, I can't really differentiate. And not to be stereotypical,
mm.
But the volume coming from them,
oh my god, they were so unbelievable. Loud.
Why do I know everything about your past relationship, how controlling your ex-boyfriend was?
She was sitting there saying,
you from Adam.
She was saying that he was the worst. Like, I couldn't even sit at a table with another guy because he got so controlling.
If I was in a class and I got paired up with a guy.
Were they in high school?
I think they were in high school or college. If I was in a class.
Because she kept talking about maths.
Yeah, and I got paired with a guy for a project. Like, he would lose his shit. And I was thinking, shut up.
But also.
Why are you telling the beach?
She was talking about him for so long, and then I think you went and got in the sea, and then she said, but yeah, I'm with another guy now and he's great. And then the girl she was with was like, oh, like, you have another boyfriend? And she was like, yeah, like, he's the best. And literally didn't say a word about him. And I was thinking, well, if he's so great and you hate your other ex.
You know, at first, I thought they were talking about Kim and Kanye. Because she was saying, I thought she said Kanye. And then she was
she said, I'm not going to say the word.
She said
the 50p word.
A very rude swear word that begins with a C. And ends in a T. I thought she said Kanye. And she's talking about Kim and Kanye. And then she was... I thought she meant, like, he's so controlling when, like, they're, like, getting divorced. And I was like, wow, this girl's so invested. Honestly. Like, I love Kim Kardashian, but fucking hell. She's, like, proper cares about Kim
Kanye. She said he's a...
50p word.
And then she was going... Talking about being controlling, da 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 da.
Right.
So she did not say Kanye.
Well, that, yeah, I clocked on then because she was going on and on and
I think his name was Jeremy. I think that's what she said, I'm sure.
Who is sprung off a guy called Jeremy?
You get your feelings hurt by a Jeremy? But yeah, and then the other one was talking about her potential boyfriend, the boy she's, like, seeing. But she said, I'm not sure because sometimes he disappears for a few days. I wanted to say,
just intervened because they were telling us basically without meaning to anyway. We should just say, girls, let me stop right there.
I literally wanted to say to her, he doesn't want you.
He doesn't want you then.
Yeah, like, she was going, yeah, like, sometimes, like, he just disappears for a couple of days and then he just says, like, I just wasn't on my phone. Like, I just wasn't in the mood.
Lies.
He was sleeping for another girl, babe.
The thing is, right, it's not even like he doesn't want you. Like, we shouldn't put it like that. We should say you shouldn't want that for yourself.
Yeah.
Not to be deep here, but don't give the guys all the control. Like, oh, he doesn't want me. He, you know.
He doesn't reply to me.
He doesn't want a relationship. He doesn't reply to me. Like, he doesn't always, you know, listen to what I say. Like, no. Why are we giving him that much control? Do what you want to do. The right person will never make you feel like they're not interested in what you have to say.
Motivation.
They will never not reply. And if they do, they will give you a valid reason as to why, and they will basically explain themselves. And they won't do it regularly.
Yeah, it'll be like
just
a one-off.
And I wasn't on my phone. Bullshit. No, yeah, you were. You're on your phone texting other girls.
Everyone is on their phone all the time.
Everyone
so
on
no
their
one
phone.
Can come and say, yeah. My phone. Yes, you fucking
will. Anyone that values you, you will never have to question what the situation is. You'll never have to question how they feel because they'll make it clear.
And that is a words to live by.
And if sorry to get deep here, guys, but you know, I'm just feeling it. If you are questioning it, if there is one question mark in your head, I don't think it's right. I really don't.
The famous saying, if it's not a yes, it's a no.
But anyway, yeah, sorry, that just developed.
That kind of spiraled from the American girls on the beach. But yeah, basically they
necessary.
Were just... And there was another fucking rude woman on the beach. I wanted to punch her
she
in the face.
So rude.
Basically, there's the beach and then there's people that work at the hotel and they walk around the beach. Basically, if you need your umbrella putting up, taken down, if you need help moving a sunbed.
Well, on the back of their t-shirts, they wear it says
housekeeping. So they will help you with anything you need. But there's also a restaurant on the beach. And the people that work in this restaurant will walk around, take orders. Do you want a drink? Do you want any food? That is their job, and that is their only job. She was laying there, literally laying there like this. Excuse me. To one of the people that works in the restaurant, can you put my sunbed down? So basically, obviously your sunbed is like this, and you can obviously lay it flat. Hers was like this. She was like, can you help me put my sunbed down?
Who died and made you the queen?
But first of all, do it your fucking self. And second of all, if you can't do it, stand up. She was literally laying there.
She was laying there like a statue. Can you help me? You haven't even tried.
You haven't even done anything. Then, like, because me as well, I was trying to lay my one down and Georgia said to me, it's not moving because you're on it. So yeah. I got up and moved it. Oh, look, not that hard.
So honestly,
and then got up and left the beach, left her leftover food there, so the fucking crows came picking up her onion rings.
That's the real reason she hates her.
No, I just thought she was so fucking rude.
No, she was
her so and her rude. Little friend running around, excuse me, so every 5 minutes, excuse me, excuse me.
I literally said, I was like, if I hear her say excuse me one more time,
literally, I just really irritates me when people click at people. Don't click at people.
It's better to be too nice than not nice enough, I say.
Dad always said, manners cost nothing.
Manners cost nothing. Kindness costs nothing. So, excuse me, lady on the beach, should remember.
Manners, Mrs. Clickety Clack.
Excuse me!
Excuse me!
Excuse me! Thank you!
Excuse me! Fucking bitch.
Oh, wound me up so bad.
Really did. But yeah, we're going to go to bed now.
I hope you enjoyed our little TED talk.
Yeah. And we will vlog tomorrow, hopefully, if I remember. Every day, Georgia says to me, have you vlogged? And the answer is always, no.
No.
Anyway, see you tomorrow. Love you. Bye. Hello again, everybody. Georgia's still getting ready.
I just feel like, do you know, we're so dumb because neither of us bought a sharpener for our lip. I burnt my lips today.
Georgia's burnt her lip.
My bottom lip is tender and neither of us brought a lip pencil sharpener and both our lip lines are blood. Great. So it's like scraping wood on my burnt lips. It's great.
Scraping wood on my burnt lips. Like
sandpaper on my burnt lips.
We are going to Asia tonight, and they've sat us outside, which I'm really happy about because it's on the marina, so it's all the pretty lights, gorgeous.
Should be incredible,
hopefully. I think it will be.
I find it difficult to see how anything's going to top last night for me now, though.
I am feeling a bit tender still. Put my necklace on and it's really quite painful, but I googled it and it said that the pain should stop after 48 hours, so hopefully tomorrow there'll be no pain and it'll start to turn into tan.
Fingers crossed,
we hope. But yeah, I didn't vlog today. There's not really much point of me vlogging in the day, like we don't really do anything. We literally just chill and relax because
we literally go
that's
to the
all
pool,
we want to do.
We go to the pool, we go to the beach and we lie down. And yeah. That, I'm sorry, but that's what I wanted to do on this holiday. I haven't been abroad since 2020. And when I went abroad in 2020, I went to Venice, which is a city. So I didn't do very much lying down at all. So, you know, we're just living our dream, really.
I mean, there was a family. There was a couple at the pool and they were talking to another couple and they both have a one-year-old daughter and they were really just talking about it very loudly for ages, what felt like an eternity. And I just,
fair enough, like I don't have kids and obviously neither should, so we probably just don't get it,
but like
the amount of people find to talk about.
If I went on holiday without my child and someone came to me with their child talking about my child, I'd be like, guys.
Yeah, I'd be like, well, I didn't bring her here for a reason.
Yeah, I left her at home. Soz, don't want to talk about it.
It was a girl. They have girls.
Yeah.
Both.
It was just quite taxing to listen to be honest. And just, there was no volume control. It was just, yeah, I had to wean her. I had to make her drink cow's milk. She didn't want to drink cow's milk.
Milk.
She only drinks formula. I don't care.
Do you know what I hate? That conversation.
Literally. I just. But yeah.
Yes, I don't even mind. Like, the kid that's here, she's really cute. Right?
Yeah, she is cute.
Please.
It's just a lot. Mm. It's just a lot. But yeah, so I'll vlog dinner if I remember. Please remind me. Because I said I was going to vlog last night and I didn't. But I have inserted clips.
Yeah.
So I feel like that makes up for it. It was so fun. But yeah, pinky promise, I will vlog dinner. So we haven't yet left the hotel. We're about to leave.
But Georgia just got an email from Asia, which is where we're meant to be going, saying that our booking's cancelled. And we can't get in contact with them to tell them that no one cancelled the booking. So we're just going to turn up and hope for the best.
Well, no, I'm going to say I confirmed it and I reconfirmed it. Because they emailed me twice today and said, can you confirm your booking? Like, we just want to double check. And I said, yeah. So
basically, we're showing up.
Absolutely. Have you got your mask?
Yeah.
Have you got the room key?
Yeah.
Have you got our cards?
Yeah.
Let's go.
So yeah, and if they tell us no, then...
Well, I don't think so. But
I don't think so.
There's loads of restaurants by the marina, so hopefully we would be able to get another restaurant. If not, we'll literally have a McDonald's, but... We're going to be looking pretty good at McDonald's.
I just don't understand. Like, I'm just confused.
And also, we'll get a good picture because we'll be on the marina anyway, but that's not really the point.
But yeah, still annoying. Literally so confused by everything. I open the door, close the door, I'm so confused. Don't get anything that's going on.
Don't get it.
Just want to eat because I'm fucking starving.
Literally.
So we've got edamame for the first time ever. What are your thoughts?
But it doesn't taste like pea, but
no,
it basically is a pea.
But it is quite hard work to get out of the pod.
Yeah, you really got to bite it, and like, calm it off. I don't want to put in that much effort just to eat. It's a bit unfair.
Unfair?
That's not the right word. Strenuous for no reason. See?
All just to get two peas out.
Literally, there's another one in there, but yeah.
Was that?
Yeah, the bottom. Oh wait, that one might only have two.
I think that's a two people.
Like me and you.
We just ordered a drink. We just got back from dinner. We just ordered a drink to our room, and they sent me the lemonade, but they sent me this to open the lid. Which way do we think?
Surely the pointy end, right?
Surely.
Hey, I'll hold it. It might be ringing him back. Help me.
Oh, it just says twist to open at the top. So what the fuck is this then?
Shauna, that's not going to open like that.
Wait, so... Ow!
Oh,
don't cut yourself.
Also, by the way, they're trying to turn me into an alcoholic. I wanted one glass of wine. He said, get a bowl.
Oh, I done it. Oh. Well, it made the
sound noise.
Sorry, try not to elbow you in the face.
What, so it makes the tss and then that's it?
What the fuck?
That's meant to just be a stirrer, I think.
That's what I thought.
Oh, like I'm strong. Come on, get with the program. I'm a weak bitch. Yeah, anyway. So, Shauna ordered the drinks because I made her. Because I said, I'm fucking paying for them, so you And what did he say?
Yeah, he was like, ah, thanks.
Yeah,
he was like, I said, can I have one vodka and lemonade and then one glass of white wine?
Pinot Grigio, to be specific.
No one cares about that.
I do.
And then he was like, oh, you're still with us for another 2 or 3 days. It's cheaper to just get a bottle and then keep it in the chiller.
I said, Shauna goes, do you want a bottle? I said, no, I want a glass. She said, okay. And then she went, bear with me a moment. And she goes, get a bottle. Cheaper. I said, all right, I'll get a bottle. So now I have a bottle of wine. I don't want a bottle of wine. She was like, you better not throw up. I goes, I'm not drinking the whole bottle now.
And I don't even drink wine.
She doesn't drink it, so it would literally just be me. God, wish my parents were here. They'd fucking glug this.
Polish it off in 10 minutes,
mate. So, bottoms up and the devil laughs.
Do you know what, we didn't show them our Irish dancing the other day. Should we do it now?
Well, oh, this top is not appropriate for that. Do you think I'm secure in this top? One wrong move, it's all over.
We'll show you in a bit.
When Georgia's dressed appropriately in her dressing gown, like me. Also, sorry about our room. Housekeeping.
Didn't they tell us about bringing the drinks? She had to move her fake ponytail.
Yeah, I had to move my fake hair out of the way. It was quite embarrassing. Yeah, housekeeping didn't come till like 4 o'clock, and we were already getting ready to go out. So I was like,
because I had to wash my hair, so we were already.
I was literally in the shower, and I just heard Georgia going,
hold on 1 second. And I was like, who are you talking to?
Housekeeping was knocking on the door, right? I had the hairdryer on, so I didn't hear her the first couple of times. She was about to come in the door. I was naked, drying my hair. I literally, hold on 1 second. I was trying to put my dressing gown on. She goes, I'll come back later. I was like, yeah, okay.
I was just in the shower and I could hear all this commotion. But yeah, dinner was lovely.
Oh, we told them already our reservation wasn't
coming. Oh my god, literally walked in and said, hi, table for two, da, 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 da. Oh, you paid for it on my card, the taxi.
Yeah.
Thanks for the heads up.
Well, I pay for every single Uber, so excuse me for getting a £5 taxi on your card, mate. Don't break the bank.
Tuning you out. I don't care. You just didn't tell me.
You said pick. Here's the card holder. Pick a card. I said it will. I'll pick yours. Bye.
Dick. Anyway. Oh, I forgot what I was saying now. I'll come back when we're Irish dancing.
Guys, we had a trauma. We're currently going down to the beach because we didn't want to get an Instagram picture at the restaurant because everyone that works at the restaurant was a bastard. I'm going down like this because I've got a bikini on underneath because I want to take a picture in front of the lights.
Well, that's what happens when you stand right behind me.
Excuse me, don't take that poor service out on me, all right? I weren't feeding you a pizza.
But yeah, the restaurant was basically just ridiculous. Everyone that worked there was so rude and the service was terrible. And yeah, so.
Not impressed.
Would not recommend Gao.
Don't
bother. Don't bother going there.
But the thing that's annoying is that because of where it is, it's right by the Burj Khalifa and it's got an amazing view. That's why people go there.
Like, yeah.
Basically for Instagram pictures, which we didn't even get because we were like, I hate it here. I
want to get out.
Literally. But that's the problem. They can get away with it. They can do what they want.
Because people will still go there.
People still go there. We're going to take George's picture on the beach.
Yeah.
Because I need that picture. And I'm
for a few moments.
And I'm so just gonna take a picture in a bikini. Also, worst restaurant of the week and the most expensive, that's what I was gonna say.
Fact.
Fuming.
Guys, welcome back to the vlog. Sorry I haven't vlogged today, but we're at the mall. I don't know if you can hear me. We're standing right in front of the fountain.
Amazing. This is the biggest and best mall I've ever seen. There is an ice rink. There is a roller coaster. There is cars, which call themselves taxis, which drive around the mall, taking you from shop to shop. Insane.
I'll show you the waterfall. It's massive. And there's two. There's one over there, and then there's this one here.
Craziness.
But yeah, we're about to go to Shake Shack. Last time I came to Dubai, I said to Georgia, the Shake Shack was the best thing I've ever had. So.
And basically, because obviously we didn't book dinner for tonight, we just said, oh, we'll just eat, like, make it casual. So we're going to go to Shake Shack, then we're going to hit Big Zara. Big, massive, fat Zara.
Big, fat Zara.
Big, fat Zara. Going to get a perfume, hopefully.
We want, like, a really cool, like, Dubai perfume.
Yeah, like, one basically that you can't get at home, yeah, is what I want. And like I was in Sephora and he showed me this gorgeous Dolce & Gabbana one, which yeah, amazing, but I can get that, I can order online. So we're gonna do that. And lastly, cheesecake from Cheesecake Factory. So excited.
I'll see you guys in a bit. Just come into Zara. This is the most insane Zara I've ever been into in my life. I'm gonna show you. Like everything is just so, wow. Georgia's obviously in the green corner because she loves it here.
I mean, I'm wearing all green.
Oh,
now.
Look, they're my heels that I have.
Beautiful.
This,
there's so much green.
It's just amazing. Like, this whole shop is just unreal. Oh, I love that.
That's beautiful.
It's like Jacquemus vibes,
but again,
satin.
Why is everything satin? Like, some people sweat, me. Some people don't. Ha, you know.
I love a satin dress.
Hey guys, we're packing. But
well,
Georgia's packing.
I'm sad, I don't wanna go.
Also, I need to sort this dressing gown.
So it'll be inappropriado on the vlog.
Yeah, I'm sad. I don't want to leave.
We've got some gorgeous perfume in
there. Oh my god, delicious. Speaking of which, can you actually unwrap that? Because I'm going to nestle it in all these clothes.
I'm going to nestle it. Just nestle.
I'm just going to nestle it, yeah. In these clothes.
God, he wrapped it up so tight.
I know. As I was watching him do it, I was thinking, babe, don't bother. It's going in my case. I'm going home tomorrow. I really don't want to go home.
That's my one, the one we're going with a H. Oh. Two H's. So your one must be in that one.
I was about to say you better stop it right now.
Why did he give me two? I didn't ask.
I think that was the point. That was the deal. So I mean, you get a discount if you buy two. So maybe he just gave us two each.
I'm opening this because I'm confused.
Oh wait, I've got it. He said because mine didn't come with an oil and a cream.
Right.
It did.
Well, don't open it then. That must be mine.
Is that right?
Yeah. So he said basically I'll give you me the box and I'll give you them two.
Right.
As a deal. Oh, that's a good deal for you.
That is good. Got 275ml bottle of perfume.
For £99.
That's pretty good if you ask me.
Right.
Gonna be smelling like a goddess.
Literally. So basically if you see either us and we smell nice, just say, oh, what's that perfume? Well, you can't smell like us, so don't even ask.
You can't. You're not allowed.
I am gatekeeping
Arabian
perfume. All right. So you can't have any.
Yeah, you're not allowed ransack.
So don't even ask me. Don't even ask me. I will not tell you.
Gonna smell like a princess.
I'll be one of those people. Oh, my brother's sister's best friend cousin got in. Bye, babe. You can't get it.
I'm gonna say, oh, my sister's boyfriend's goldfish party bought it for me. And unfortunately,
it's not so. Oh, I got it in a little boutique. I got it in a little boutique abroad, I'm afraid.
You can't have it.
They don't sell it in this country, unfortunately.
You cannot have it.
Oh, God, guys, I ain't got room. How's that possible? I didn't buy any more clothes.
Also, 1,000,000% overpacked. Like, oh my God.
So much. When I come to pack my case, it's going to be a joke.
The amount we overpacked is genuinely actually insane. Because I don't know what we thought we were doing, like 20 outfit changes a day.
Is that the Irish jig?
No. That's just me jumping side to side. I can do the Irish jig.
Did it.
Let me change the angle.
We never did it.
This is it. Are you ready?
Ready. Oh God, this dress is a little bit small.
Oh no, be careful.
And that is the skin.
And that is that, ladies and gents. Michael Flatley, Lord of the Dance.
Years of professional dance training
have led to that moment.
Oh my God, that is fucking funny. Oh, can you swear on YouTube?
I don't know, I do all the time.
Oh. Okay.
Apparently you're not meant to, but I don't know why.
So, I did bring a pair of sandals with me and they're absolutely destroyed, so they're going in the bin. I'm not going home. Those two pairs of shoes, I might need to put in your case. Well,
my case?
You brought them ones for me, so you can definitely fit one pair in.
Yeah.
So, just stick another pair in.
Oh. Are you not putting your bags in your bag?
Oh my God! Sugar!
Yeah.
What a silly lady.
I actually am. What the fuck?
Mate, this is sick.
I don't think any of this should actually make it onto the internet, if I'm being honest.
Oh, bloody
hell. I could definitely be a dancer.
Not being funny, how did I fit all this in?